Okay, so hello everyone, welcome to BVLSI Design lecture number 31B. Today we are going to discuss 2:4 decoder using NMOS pass transistor logic for active high outputs. So let us first understand the concept of 2:4 decoder. So here is my general structure, having two select lines A0 and A1 and having four outputs D0, D1, D2, D3. Basically your decoder circuits are used in the memory to select a certain section of a memory, right? So that is why we require we require decoder circuits. In this case, we are building transistor level implementation of a 2:4 decoder. So A1, depending upon the status of A0 and A1, we have a particular output line high. So for A1, A0 as 0, 0, D1 is high. For 0, 0, D0 is high. For 0, 1, D1 is high. 1, 0, D2 is high. And for 1, 1, D3 is high. Rest for all other cases, it is 0. So this is what you mean by active high outputs. So here in this case, A1 and A0 are the select inputs. And D0 to D3 are my four outputs. And here we are assuming that we have a stronger NMOS transistors as compared to the PMOS transistors. Okay, now let us check the circuit. Okay, so this is my circuit. So we have four PMOS transistors, right, connected like this, whose gate terminal is connected to the ground. That means all these PMOS transistors are on MP1, MP2, MP3, MP4. So as soon as you apply the power supply, all these are on, right? And now we are taking the bits over here like this, output lines. This is D0, D1, D2, D3. Okay. And here we have connected two NMOS pass transistors with the input A1 together to this D1 line and this D0 line. Okay. We will see soon the functionality, why we are doing this. Then A1 bar will be connected to the D3 and D2 line. I mean, as you can see, one of the terminal is connected for the NMOS transistors. Other terminal of the NMOS transistor is grounded. So basically, whenever this transistor is on, it will pass a logic 0 to this line. Okay. Similarly, for A0, we are connecting it to D0 and D2 line, MN6 and MN5. And simultaneously, for A0 bar, we are connecting to D3 and D1 line. Okay. So this is the output line, D1. D0, D1, D2, D3. And we have to implement A1 bar. We have to generate A1 bar and A0 bar from A0 and A1. So here we are generating A0 bar from A1 by using a CMOS inverter, static CMOS inverter. And here from A1, we are generating A1 bar using another static CMOS inverter. So this is my implementation of 2:4 decoder using NMOS pass transistor logic. Okay, this is the entire circuit. If you're noting it down, note it down. So every output line will be pulled up by this pull-up PMOS transistor, whose gate terminal is connected to the ground. And all other transistors other than that are made up of NMOS. They are acting as NMOS pass transistors. That means if any of the particular NMOS transistor is on, it will pass a logic 0. Because other terminal is connected to ground, so it will pass a logic 0 to that line. So now we have already seen the truth table. And here we assume only one thing, that we assume that we have a stronger NMOS transistors as compared to the PMOS transistors. So let us explain the first case over here. I mean, let me reduce the width slightly. Yeah, this is fine. So in this case, we are getting D0 bit as 1. Rest all the bits as 0. Now let's see how that is possible. So we have applied A0 and A1 as 0, 0. Okay. So whenever I apply a logic 0 to the gate terminal of NMOS transistor, that will be off. So all the transistors which are marked in green color are off. So MN1 transistor is off, MN2 transistor is off, MN5 transistor is off, and MN6 transistor is off. And to the contrary, A1 bar and A0 bar are 1 and 1. So MN3 transistor is on, MN4 transistor is on, so it passes logic 0. As you can see, it passes logic 0 to this node, D3 output line. And this MN4 passes logic 0 to this D2 D2 output line. Similarly, your A0 bar is 1. So MN7 is on and it passes logic 0 to D3 output line. And MN8 is on, so it passes logic 0 to D1 output line. So since PMOS transistors are also on, it is trying to pull the output voltage towards VDD. But since we have NMOS transistor as a stronger one, so these two lines, you can see on D3 line. In D3 line, your this NMOS transistor is passing a logic 0. And this is also passing a logic 0. So we have a strong logic 0 at D3. Similarly, at D2, one line, I mean, MN5 is off, so it will not have effect. But another NMOS transistor, MN4, is passing a strong logic 0 at over here. So D2 will also be storing 0. Same is the story with D1. MN8 is passing a logic 0. So on the line D1, we will have a logic 0. Whereas in case of D0, in case of D0, we have two transistors, MN2 and MN6, which are off. Correct? So, I mean, it is as good as ki the output is, you know, we are passing over here VDD at the output of D1. Why? Because MP4 transistor is always on, right? But here, no other PMOS, NMOS transistor is connected. So what will happen? My D0 will be storing, I mean, will be having a logic 1 at its terminal. Okay? Because this PMOS transistor is on and this VDD will be connected to the output of D0 output line. Now let us check the next case. In the next case, we have A0 as 0. A0 as 1 and A1 as 0. So A1 0 means these two transistors which are marked in green color are off. Correct? And your A1 bar will be 1. So that means MN3 and MN4 transistors are on. It will pass logic 0 to the D3 and D2 lines. Similarly, A1 is on. So it will pass MN5 is on. So it will pass logic 0 to D2 line. And MN6 will pass a logic 0 to D0 line. And A0 is 0. So MN7 and MN8 are off. Now you can appreciate why D0 is 0. It is storing 0 because MN3 is on. D2 is also storing logic, I mean, it's also having logic 0 at its terminal, output terminal, because MN4 and MN5 are passing strong logic 0 to it. Because it's an NMOS transistor, it will pass logic 0 strongly. Now, in case of D1, we'll have both the NMOS transistors are off, as you can see very clearly. So, what will happen? MP3 transistor, which is on, it will store the value D1 will be having a VDD level. Okay, because this PMOS transistor will pass a strong logic 1 to its output terminal. Okay, so D1 will be storing logic 1. Why D0 is 0? Because MP6 transistor being on, it will pass a logic 0 to it. Okay, now similarly, we will consider two other cases quickly. So in this case, we have A1 and A1 is 1 and A0 is logic 0. So if it is logic 0, MN5 and MN6 are off. And A1 bar is also logic 0. So MN3 and MN4 are also off. So only MN1, MN2, MN7 and MN8 transistors are on. Let's check the status at D3. At D3, we have, you know, MN7 on. So it will pass logic 0. So hence we have a logic 0 over here. D2 line, well, none of the transistors are on. Or none of the NMOS transistors are on. So PMOS transistor will pass a strong logic 0, a strong logic 1 at its output terminal, that is D3 line, sorry, D2 line. So in the D2 will be having a logic 1 or a VDD voltage. For a D1, well, MN1 and MN8 transistors are on and they pass logic 0. So hence D1 is storing 0 and D0 is 0 because MN2 is on and storing 0. Okay. Now let's check the last case. Here we have A1 and A0 as 1. So A0 bar and A1 bar will be 0. That means MN3, MN4 is off. MN7 and MN8 are also off. And now what's the status of D3 line? In D3 line, none of the NMOS transistors are on. So your MP1 transistor will be passing a strong logic 1. Okay, we have connected VDD to its one terminal. So other terminal also will be passing VDD voltage. Hence D3 will be logic 1. What about D2? For D2, your MN5 is on and it passes a logic 0. So hence D2 is having logic 0 at its terminal. D1, for D1, MN1 is on and passes logic 0. So D1 is storing logic 0 at its terminal. I mean, we have a logic 0 at its terminal. And for D0, both MN2 and MN6 are on, and they will pass a logic 0 to the D0 terminal. So in this way, we can explain all the cases of a 2:4 decoder with the help of this truth table. Okay, so I have made one circuit in LTSpice exactly similar. So these are my, let me expand it and show it to you. These are my four PMOS transistors whose gate terminal is grounded. And these are my four output lines, D0, D1, D2, D3. If you observe it carefully, it will be exactly similar. Okay, let me minimize this. And let me show you the circuit over here. Okay, so here it is. This is my two transistors connected to this. Here we have another two transistors like this with the input as A1 bar. Here also we have A1 bar. And these are the two transistors connected with the input A0. And these are the last two transistors connected over here and here, which is A0 bar input. Okay, so the circuit is perfectly fine. Now let us check the... We have put two more additional CMOS inverters to generate A0 bar from A0 and A1 bar from A1. Okay. And we have given the MOSFET parameters as, for PMOS, we have given W as 16. Okay. Right. And actually, we should give double the value normally. But it's okay. Fine. We can give it as 8. Right. And this KP value is around 25 micro. And VTO is around minus 0.7. For PMOS, for NMOS, we'll have W as 8 micro and a VTO as 0.7 and KP is 50. So relatively right now, PMOS and NMOS both are same level. Are at the same stronger level. Fine. So none of them is stronger than the other. Let us check the output. What do we get? So A0 and A1, we have given the pulse. So for A0, we have given 0 to 5. Delay time is 5 millisecond. Rise time and fall time is 1 picosecond. On time is 6 milli and period is 12. And number of cycles are 10. And for A1, everything is same, except that the delay time is 2 millisecond. Rest everything is same. Okay, on time is 6 milli, period is 12. Rise time and fall time is 1 picosecond. And we are going from 0 to 5. Okay, so let me simulate this. I'll click on go to simulate, click on run. And then I have to divide it into 6 planes. Why 6 planes? 4 output and 2 select lines. Okay, so I'll add one more plane over here and then I'll go back to the waveform part over here. So first we'll plot A1. Next we will plot A0. Next will be D0. Followed by D1. Followed by D2. And lastly, the output will be D3. Okay, so do not worry whether how strange waveforms you are getting over here. Correct? But only when it is not able to pass logic 0 perfectly. Okay, let me give you a proof. So these are my waveforms, right? Let me go back over here and come back to the truth table. And let me reduce slightly the time period so that I can have more such clarity. So let me make it as around, let's say, 20 milliseconds. Okay, I'll simulate it again. Yeah, here I'm in a much better picture. Okay, so now A0 and A1, so they are 0, 0. So when they are 0, 0, D0 will be 1. D0 will be logic 1, as you can see very clearly. It is logic 1, 5 volt, perfectly. But D1 should be 0, but it is not 0. Okay, it is not 0, it is actually around 2.5. Similarly, D2. D2 is not 0, again it is 2.5. D3 is also around, D3 is going to 0. I mean, D3 is not going to 0, it is actually half of 2.5 almost. It is 1.2395. Okay, why it is so? Why we are getting not as logic 0? We should get it as 0, right? Why we are getting this way? The reason why we are getting this is because your NMOS and PMOS transistor are of equal strength. We have to consider NMOS strong transistor to be much, much stronger as compared to PMOS. We will do that in a bit. Let us check the next case. Next case, we have A1 and A0 as 1, 0. So for 1, 0, we should have D2 as 1. So over here, D2 is logic 1, as you can see. Logic 1, it is perfectly, reaching up till 5 volt, as you can see over here. Let me select D2. And for this particular condition, it's storing 5. But at the same time, D0, D1, and D3 should be storing logic 0. But they are not. Now, let us make the transistor, NMOS transistor, stronger. So let me make this as, let's say, 100. And let me, instead of 8, give it as, let's say, 32. So we have increased the strength a lot for the NMOS transistors. So now you see much, much better, right? So for the first case, A0, A1 as 0, 0, we are getting D0 as you can see very clearly. D0 as logic 1, D1, D2, and D3 as logic 0. Let us check the voltage levels. So yeah, we are getting very less now. It's around 277 millivolt, that is around 0.277 volt. That can be treated as logic 0. But still, we can, if we make the transistor even stronger, we may, get even better results. So let's make it stronger. Let's make it 64. And let us check now whether we are getting much better results. Yes. Almost zero we are getting. So over here, if we can check, we are getting 136 millivolt. That is around 0.136 volt. That is acceptable. If we make it more stronger, we may get even lesser than that. Okay. So let's check all the cases over here for A0 and A1 as 0, 0. So we are getting D0 as logic 1. Rest all the cases we have D1, D2, D3 are logic 0. For the second case, we have 1, 0. So for 1, 0, D2 will be logic 1 and rest all will be logic 0, as you can see clearly. For the next case, we have 1 and 1 again. 1 and 1. So for 1 and 1, D3 will be on. Okay, and it is on. There's D1, D0, and D2 will be logic 0. Next, we have 0, 0 again. So again over here, 0, 1. So for 0, 1, we'll have D1 as 1. So as you can see, D1 is logic 1, which is 5 volt around. And for the next case, again, we are back to the same condition, 0, 0. So D0 will be on. In this way, we can check the remaining cases. It will be symmetric. Again, we can check it quickly. For 1, 0, D2 is on, rest all are off, logic 0. And for 1 and 1, my D3 is on. So in this way, my functionality of 2:4 decoder is verified. Only thing is that we have to make NMOS transistor much, much stronger as compared to my PMOS transistor. Then only you will get this outputs. I showed you the scenarios. So this circuit over here, which we have implemented in LTSpice, indeed behaves as a 2:4 decoder circuits, which is normally used in the memory to select the memory locations. Okay, from two select lines, we can select many memory locations, 4 outputs we have. Okay, so that is the use of 2:4 decoder circuit. And this we have built it using NMOS pass transistor logic. Only condition is that NMOS transistor has to be much, much stronger as compared to the PMOS transistors. And this is the output. We have verified the entire truth table. Okay. So I think we have complete. The total transistor count is 16 over here. 4 over here and 2. So 6, 8. Then here we'll require another 2. So 10, 12. And 4 transistors for the 2 CMOS inverter. So total transistor required to build 2:4 decoder circuit is 16. Okay. So we have come to the end of this session. And we have implemented 2:4 decoder circuit using NMOS pass transistor logic. We have seen the working conceptually over here in OneNote PDF, considering all the cases of the truth table. And we have also done the simulation and verified the results and the waveforms and the truth table in LTSpice also. Okay, I think that is all for today's session. Next time we will begin with some other topic. Until then, have a good day and thank you.